In the previous lecture, we discussed in detail op-amp circuits. We looked at a couple of example op-amp circuits, and also I emphasized that op-amp has to be used in negative feedback, and I also mentioned how to find the signs of the op-amp in any circuit such that it is in negative feedback. Okay, an op-amp is basically a voltage controlled voltage source with a very large gain. Because the gain is very large and it's a negative feedback, it forces the input signal of the op-amp to be a very small value, which can be considered to be zero. And if the gain of the op-amp goes to infinity, that is the idealized version of this, which we call the ideal op-amp. In that case, the input difference voltage of the op-amp can be is assumed to be zero. Okay, and there is no input current into the op-amp. So based on these things, you can analyze any op-amp circuit that you have. Okay, so if there are any questions regarding what we did in the last lecture, please go ahead now. Otherwise, we'll start with today's topics. So far, we have looked at circuits that have resistors and control sources and so on, and all these are known as memoryless elements. What is meant by this is that the current at instant t depends only on voltage at instant t. That is, it doesn't depend on the voltage at any other instant. Okay. Or similarly, if you have a voltage to current relationship, the relationship is exactly the same and for all instants, and more importantly, the voltage at some instant is related to current at that instant only. Okay. Similarly, for controlled sources, the control quantity is related to the controlling quantity instantaneously, only at that instant. Now, if we have capacitors and inductors, we know these properties are not true. If you have a capacitor, the voltage across the capacitor depends on not only the current at that instant, but on the history of the current. Similarly, if you have the current through the inductor, it depends not only on the voltage across the inductor, but on the history of the voltage across the inductor. Okay. So, capacitors and inductors are elements with memory. Okay. So what we will do in this lecture is to try and analyze circuits which have inductors and capacitors in addition to resistors. Is this okay? Any questions? So let me take a circuit that we are all familiar with, a resistive divider. Okay. Now let's say I call this VS and the voltage is zero. Okay. What will be the output voltage? Please try to answer this. What is the output voltage? When I say output, in this case, I have defined the output to be this particular voltage. Okay. What is that voltage going to be? What will be the voltage here when the input voltage VS is zero? Anybody, what's the voltage going to be? So this voltage clearly from the voltage divider formula is Vs times R2 by R1 plus R2. Okay, and if Vs is 0, this voltage is also 0. Okay, this is a simple resistive divider. Now let's say it jumps from 0 to some voltage Vp. Okay, what happens then? The output voltage jumps from 0 to Vp times R2 by R1 plus R2. Okay, so you can see that the variation of the output voltage with time, the horizontal axis here is time, this is time, and here also it is time. The variation of the output voltage with time is exactly the same as the variation of the input voltage with time with a scaling factor. Okay, now let's say we do something. We have Vs and I replace R2 with a capacitor and I have R and C. Okay, what happens in this case? Let's say initially the capacitor voltage is at 0. Okay. And the input is also 0. Clearly, in that case, what happens is that the capacitor voltage is 0, and because Vs is 0, no current flows through the resistor, which means no current through the capacitor. So if there is no current through the capacitor, its voltage cannot change. Okay, so in this case the voltage remains at 0 if the input is 0. Now let's say the input jumps from 0 to Vp. Okay, what happens to the voltage? Please try to answer this. Let me call this Vc. We see when Vs jumps from 0 to Vp. Okay. Please, some of you attempt to answer this. What is the voltage Vc going to be when Vs jumps from 0 to Vp? Okay, we have an answer. It says that one over C integral I of t dt. Okay, this is correct, but the only issue we have now is that we don't even know what this I of t is. Okay, so that also we have to solve for. I mean, we have done this for the simpler circuit before. The current in this is Vs by R1 plus R2. Okay. Whereas here we have to find out, and the current itself depends on the voltage of the capacitor. Okay. So now what I would like to do is to write the equation for this circuit so that I can solve it. What I'll do is this. I'll write KCL at this node. Okay. So the current through this, I will express everything in terms of the capacitor voltage Vc. So the current through this is C times dVc by dt. We know that that is the current through a capacitor which has a voltage Vc across it. Okay. Now that has to be equal to the current coming from the resistor. So what is the current through the resistor in terms of Vc? Please try to answer this. Okay, that is correct. So the capacitor current, which is C times dVc by dt, equals the current in the resistor, which is Vs minus Vc divided by R. Okay. What I will do is I will group all of the terms containing Vc to the left hand side, and I'll also multiply both sides with R. So I'll get Rc dVc by dt plus Vc equals Vs. Okay. Now this is a feature of circuits containing capacitors or inductors or both, that the equation governing the circuit will be a differential equation. Okay. Whereas previously we could write, if I still call this Vc, there is no capacitor here, I will just call that voltage Vc. Vc equals Vs R2 by R1 plus R2. Okay. So it's an algebraic equation. Whereas in this case, it's a differential equation if you have resistors or capacitors. Okay, so we have to solve the differential equation to find the solution. Okay, so let's try and do that. So before that, we will try and solve a couple of cases intuitively, and then go on to finding the solution of the differential equation. Okay, any questions so far? So let me rewrite the circuit and the equation again. Okay, this is the circuit, and for arbitrary inputs, it's not very easy to solve for these things. So we'll take specific kinds of input. So initially, in particular, I will take an input that goes from 0 to VP at a particular time instant. Okay, so this is t, and let's say this is t equals 0. Okay, and we also know that the differential equation governing this is RC dVc by dt plus Vc equals Vs. Okay, so now first let's forget the differential equation and try to sketch the output based on what we know about resistor, capacitor and the voltage. Okay, I already said that initially the voltage across the capacitor is 0. Okay, so if I try to plot Vc versus time, okay, before t equal to 0, the voltage will be 0. So that's what I have assumed. Okay, so this is because I say initial condition, but I really mean for t less than 0. Okay, on the capacitor. Now, at the instant that the Vs steps from 0 to Vp, okay, what happens to the capacitor? Will it change? Will the capacitor voltage change? When I say t at t equal to 0, I mean at this instant will it suddenly change? That's the question. What do you think? Yeah, so as Aarti answered, the capacitor voltage cannot change suddenly. Now, as I emphasized before, this means that we are already assuming that the currents are finite. Okay, so if the current is infinite, the capacitor voltage can change suddenly, but the current is finite, and in this case we cannot have infinite current. Okay, because if we do have infinite current through the capacitor, it means that we also have infinite current through the resistor, which in turn means an infinite voltage across the resistor. Okay, so this capacitor voltage will not change, will not jump at t equal to 0. Okay, now my question is, what is the current through the capacitor at t equal to 0? What is the capacitor current at t equal to 0? So clearly it is Vs by R or Vp by R, because the value of Vs is Vp. So the capacitor current at t equal to 0, this is Vp divided by R. Okay, so that means that this current IC at t equal to 0 is Vp by R. Now, because the current is flowing through the capacitor, its voltage tends to increase. Its voltage tends to change, and from the direction of the current, we know that VC is going to increase. Okay. So what happens is it increases. So I'll show a little bit of increase like this. Now, what is the slope of this increase going to be? What will be the slope? Please try to find out, because we know the current through the capacitor. So we should know the slope of the voltage across the capacitor. Okay? Because the capacitor current is nothing but C times dV by dt, dVc by dt. So the current through the capacitor is basically related to the slope of the voltage across the capacitor. Okay? So what is the slope of the capacitor voltage versus time? So when I say slope of the capacitor voltage versus time, obviously it should have dimensions of volts over time, volts per second, something like that, right? So we know the capacitor current Vp by R, okay? So we have to equate that, we have to use that in the equation for the capacitor current and find out the slope of the capacitor voltage. Please try to calculate that. So someone please try to answer this question. So the current through the capacitor is Vp by R, which also in terms of the capacitor voltage is C times dVc by dt. Okay. So what I was looking for was dVc by dt, the slope of the capacitor voltage. Okay. So clearly that is equal to Vp by RC. Okay. So the slope at t equal to 0 will be Vp by RC. Okay. So it increases a little bit. I have shown it with this blue line over here. Now, let's say after it increases a little bit, let's say I have come to this point. What happens then to the current through the capacitor? Please try to answer this. Now, initially, at this point, the current equals Vp by R. What will it be at the other point? A little bit. For t a little bit more than 0, the capacitor voltage increases. So what happens to the current through the capacitor in this circuit? Somebody please attempt this, current through the capacitor here. what happens to the current through the capacitor? So there is an answer that says slope less than 1, but keep in mind that here we are plotting voltage versus time. So the slope is measured in volts per second. Okay. So when we have a dimension quantity like that, it doesn't make sense to say it is less than 1. Okay. So it has to be less than some quantity. Okay. So another answer is that it is Vp by R, but is it true? Why is it Vp by R? What is the voltage across the resistor now? The voltage across the resistor at this time instant, what is it going to be? Is it Vp? Is it less than Vp? Is it more than Vp? Exactly. So the current through the capacitor is Vp minus Vc by R. Now, when the capacitor voltage was 0, the current was Vp by R. But when the capacitor voltage increases a little bit, the current will decrease. Okay. So the current here is smaller than the current there. Now, what does that mean? Because the current is proportional to the slope of the capacitor voltage, or the other way around, the capacitor voltage, the slope of the capacitor voltage is proportional to the current through it. So the capacitor voltage will increase a little, okay, but after that the slope will reduce because the current has reduced. Now if you look at this point, the voltage across the capacitor has increased further, okay, so that means the current through it is reduced further. If the capacitor voltage increases, the voltage across the resistor decreases, because the capacitor voltage plus resistor voltage equals Vp. Okay, in this time, in this range of time, it equals Vp, which is a constant. So as capacitor voltage increases, the resistor voltage decreases, so the slope reduces further. Okay, so the slope will go on reducing. Okay, now in reality it doesn't reduce in discrete steps like this. Continuously it will go on reducing, because as soon as the capacitor voltage increases a little bit, the slope will reduce, then it increases a little further, it will reduce, and so on. Okay, it turns out that the slope will go on reducing, then finally it will asymptotically reach some value. Okay, it will reach some value, and after that the voltage does not change much. Okay, so the slope becomes almost zero. Now what is this voltage? What is the voltage it almost reaches? What is the voltage at which it stops changing further? Please try to answer this. Clearly, if the capacitor voltage is Vp, the voltage here is also Vp, and the resistance has 0 volts across it, so that means there is no current flowing through it. Okay, so the capacitor voltage is Vp and there is no current through the capacitor, so that means that the capacitor voltage will not change at all. Okay, so this would be equal to Vp. Okay. So I hope this intuitive description of how an RC circuit responds to a step is clear. If not, please ask your questions and I will clarify it further. What happens is, let's say you start from a discharged capacitor, that is a capacitor which has no charge, and in this circuit at t equal to 0 there will be no infinite currents, so the capacitor voltage will not change instantaneously. But at t equal to 0, because the input voltage increased to Vp, the current will increase. Okay, so the current through the capacitor increases, and sorry, the current through the capacitor will be non-zero, it will be Vp by R. So that means that the voltage across the capacitor increases. As the voltage across the capacitor increases, the voltage across the resistor reduces, and that reduces the current and the slope of the capacitor voltage. Okay, and this happens continuously. The capacitor voltage will increase little by little, and the current through it will reduce little by little, reducing the slope of increase. Finally, the slope of the capacitor voltage almost becomes zero, and you can kind of say that the capacitor voltage reaches some value, and that value is Vp. That's because the capacitor voltage will stop changing when the current through this is zero. Okay, and if the current through this is zero, current through the resistor is zero, the voltage drop across the resistor is zero, so that means that here also you have Vp. Okay, so please think about this and ask me any questions you may have. The slope is Vp by R at t equal to 0. Slope gradually reduces as Vc increases. And we see asymptotically reaches Vp. What is meant by asymptotically is that it gets very, very close to Vp but doesn't quite get there. It gets there only at t equal to infinity. Okay. So finally, when Vc equals Vp, current through the resistor and the capacitor is zero, and Vc doesn't change anymore. Okay. So, any questions about this behavior of an RC circuit for a step input? This kind of input which jumps from one value to another value is known as a step input. Now, let's go the other way around, just for completing the calculation. Okay, so let's say initially the voltage Vs is at Vp, and the capacitor voltage Vc is also at Vp for t less than 0. Okay, so imagine that we take the capacitor and charge it up to Vp. Okay, so previously we charged it almost to Vp, so we charge it up to Vp, and then after some time we bring the input Vs down to 0. Okay, so this is exactly the opposite of what we had earlier. Instead of going from 0 to Vp, we go from Vp to 0. Okay, so now if you look at the differential equation that governs this circuit, it is Rc dVc by dt plus Vc equals Vs, and this is nothing but 0 for t greater than 0. Okay, so we have a differential equation with 0 on the right hand side. That's the differential equation that governs this particular circuit in this condition. Okay, so again I plot Vc versus time. So like I said initially, Vc is at a value Vp. Okay, and also for convenience I will redraw the circuit with Vs equal to 0. Okay, with Vs equal to 0, it's a short circuit. And I have this C and R, and the voltage across this is Vp at t equal to 0. Okay, now what will be the current through the capacitor? Okay, so let's say I call this as Ic, and because Vs equals 0, I have shown it as a short circuit. So if the capacitor current is flowing like this, I have used the passive sign convention. What is the current Ic? So there is an answer Vp by R, but please mind the signs, because I've used passive sign convention for Ic. So flowing from top to bottom, that's right. First of all, the voltage across the capacitor and the resistor, they are the same in this circuit, they are in parallel. Okay, so this voltage with this polarity is Vp at t equal to 0, which means that a current Vp by R flows in that direction. So this Ic, which is the current flowing from top to bottom in the capacitor, is minus Vp by R. Okay, okay, so what happens to the capacitor voltage after t equal to 0? Capacitor voltage Vc for t greater than 0, what happens now? Will it increase or decrease or remain the same? So that's right, it's going to decrease. Okay, so it will decrease, and the slope is again given by the capacitor current. Okay, minus Vp by R is the capacitor current, C dVc by dt. So dVc by dt is nothing but minus Vp by Rc. Okay, so the slope is minus Vp by Rc. Okay, So there was a question here that was whether after charging a capacitor to some voltage, can we use it as a voltage source? Yes, we can. In fact, it is used like that in some cases. But of course, you have to remember that a capacitor is not a voltage source. As you draw current from it, its voltage is going to change. Okay. So after some point, the voltage changes so much that you can't use it anymore. Okay. So let's say you want a 5 volt source, you can charge a capacitor to 5 volts and use it. But as you draw current from it, the voltage will start decreasing, and at some point it may go so far below 5 volts that it may be useless. Okay. But in fact, this is used if you want a source for a very short time where you are not drawing so much charge or so much current from the capacitor, you can use that. In fact, in many electronic gadgets, when you want to change batteries, okay, during the time you take to change the battery, there will be no source. So some of those gadgets may use a very large capacitor. Okay, so in the time that you take to change the battery, the capacitor will be acting like a voltage source and supplying power. Okay, but of course it cannot do it indefinitely. So if you leave it without batteries for a long time, it will just discharge and die out. Okay. So the slope is minus Vp by Rc. Now let's say we come to this point. Okay. So what happens to the slope after that? What happens to the current through the capacitor, and what happens to the slope of the voltage across the capacitor? The voltage across the capacitor is decreasing, but after it decreases a little bit, what happens to the slope of the voltage? Now clearly, the voltage across the resistor is also Vc, and as Vc reduces, the voltage across the resistor reduces, which means that the current through it reduces. And if the current reduces, okay, the slope of the voltage also reduces. So it does that, and then does that, that, and that, and so on. Okay. So finally, it turns out that it will asymptotically reach zero, because the input is zero for t greater than zero. And if this capacitor voltage goes all the way to zero, then there will be no current through the resistor, and that means that the capacitor voltage cannot change at all, which in turn means that the capacitor has reached its steady state. Okay. So this asymptotically goes to zero. Okay. Is this clear? Any questions about this? Okay. So now we have looked at the behavior of the capacitor voltage for two cases, when the input jumps from 0 to Vp or from Vp to 0. Qualitatively, it is the same. It starts changing with a certain slope, the capacitor voltage, and the slope goes on reducing. Okay, the magnitude of the slope goes on reducing. So it starts off steeply and then becomes less and less steep, and finally asymptotically reaches some value. When you change the input from 0 to Vp, that value is Vp. When you change the input from Vp to 0, that value is 0. Okay, is this fine? So key things to remember are that are the values of the slopes and so on. Okay, so this slope is minus Vp by Rc. Okay, so it starts from Vp, and if it went like a straight line with that slope, it would cut the time axis at t equal to Rc. Okay, but of course it doesn't do that, because the moment the voltage reduces a little, the current also reduces, so the slope reduces and so on. Okay. So now, what do you think this shape is? We have done it intuitively and graphically, but we have to also be able to write a formula, an expression for Vc as a function of time. So what is that function? Any guesses for what that is? So let's see. Let me take the second case where the input Vs was 0 after t equal to 0. Okay. Okay, so for t greater than 0, this is the model with Vs set to 0. Okay, now let's see what shape it is. Somebody answered parabola. It turns out it's not a parabola. The differential equation governing this is Rc dc by dt plus Vc equals 0. Okay. Now I will rewrite this as dvc by dt is minus 1 by rc times vc. Okay. So what this equation is saying is that the derivative dvc by dt is proportional to the function itself. Okay, so the derivative is proportional to the function. So what is the function that gives you a derivative which is essentially the same function? It may be a scaled version of that function, but it is the same function. Okay, so for instance, let me do it with some other variables. I could have something like this. If I have dx by dt equal to x, okay, so in this case also the derivative is proportional to the function. In fact, I have made it exactly equal to the function. Now, you know how to differentiate functions. So, what is the function that you can recall that has the derivative which is the same function? Please try to answer this. Derivative is proportional to the function or maybe even equal to the function. What is the function that meets this criterion? So if you want, you can think of the table of derivatives that you would have studied when you studied calculus. So think of a function whose derivative is the same function. So clearly, an exponential satisfies this because the derivative of the exponential is also an exponential. Okay. So now, let's say I don't want the derivative to be equal to the function, but only proportional to the function. Okay. So I also know that if I had a scaling factor here, exponential at, and I differentiate it, I get a times exponential at. Okay. So clearly, in this case, if Vc is as an exponential, this function will be satisfied. Okay. Also, I want a particular scaling factor, right? So you see that this equation is of the same form as this. Okay. So the derivative of something equals a constant times the same function. Okay. So what is a function that will satisfy this? Satisfy this equation. It is Vc of t of the form of exponential minus t by RC. Okay. So clearly, now I also can have a scaling factor here. So let's say V0, because that will cancel out. If Vc of t is V0 exponential minus t by RC, please give me the value of dVc by dt. What is dVc by dt? If Vc is V0 exponential minus t by RC, I use these expressions to find out exactly what goes inside the exponential. If it is exponential at, the multiplying factor here is a. I want the multiplying factor to be minus 1 by RC. So a has to be minus 1 by RC. So Vc of t is V0 exponential minus t by RC. Okay. So just differentiate this and tell me what the value is. Clearly, this is minus V0 by RC exponential minus T by RC. Okay. So you can see by inspection that this will satisfy this equation. Okay. Because the derivative is minus 1 by RC. Okay. So this part of it times the rest of it, which is the function itself. Okay. So the solution to RC dVc by dt plus Vc equal to 0. The solution to this is Vc of t equals V0 exponential minus t by Rc, and V0 can be anything, okay, but as far as the differential equation is concerned. So any value of V0, this differential equation will be satisfied, okay. But in our circuit, we will need a particular value of V0. So how will we find this? How will we find the value of V0? So there is another answer which says V0 by RC exponential minus T by RC. I think you omitted a minus sign. It should be minus V0 by RC exponential minus T by RC. Okay. So now we know that the shape of this blue curve here is of the form of V0 exponential minus T by RC. So this is this exponential describes the response of these types of circuits, okay. And also we know that at t equal to 0, it starts from Vp, okay. What is the value of this function at t equal to 0? The value of this function at t equal to 0 is, if I substitute t equal to 0 in this exponential, I will get V0, okay. But I know from the circuit that it's going to be Vp. So for this to correctly describe the blue curve here, this V0 has to be Vp, okay. So this curve is Vp exponential minus T by RC, okay. This is clear. So if initially the capacitor had a voltage Vp and the input also had a voltage Vp, then the current through the capacitor, current through the resistor would be 0, current through the capacitor would be 0, and it would stay at Vp. But if Vp jumps, Vs jumps from Vp to 0, then the output will slowly discharge all the way to 0, okay, towards 0. Now, we have also determined that function. The function is Vp exponential minus T by RC, okay. And we had intuitively determined the shape, that it has some slope initially and then it goes on decreasing, okay. And that's exactly what the exponential does. Please keep in mind that this exponential is the exponential of t but with a minus sign inside, okay. So if you have an exponential with a plus sign, it will blow up, okay, it will go on increasing with time. If you have exponential of minus t by RC, it will go on decreasing with time. So any questions about this? The capacitor voltage across this will follow an exponential. I will redraw the input and output. Vs changes from Vp to 0, it jumps, okay. So this is Vs of t. And Vc of t, we'll assume initially it was at Vp and it slowly goes to 0 like that. And this is Vc of t and it equals Vp exponential minus t by RC. Okay. And the differential equation governing this is RC dVc by dt plus Vc equals 0. And the solution is Vc of t is Vp exponential minus t by RC. Okay. So by now you should be comfortable with these results. If you have any questions at all, let me know. I will clarify that further. Okay. Any questions about this? Now, in this circuit, in this condition, the condition we are evaluating is with zero input. Okay. So, if you look at this differential equation, it has only Vc. It doesn't have anything corresponding to the input. The input is zero. Okay. So, such a differential equation where the input or the right hand side is zero, okay, I will always try to group the, I will always group the variables on the left hand side and the constant inputs on the right hand side. Okay, here Vc is the variable, and this kind of an equation which has a zero on the right hand side and only terms with Vc on the left hand side, this is known as a homogeneous equation. Okay. So, if you have taken some mathematics courses on differential equations, you will be familiar with this term. But in this course, whatever we need of differential equations, we will study them ourselves. Okay. And this response, because we have zero input, is known as the zero input response. Okay. And this term which appears inside the exponential RC, this is known as the time constant. Okay. It also appears here as coefficient of dVc by dt, but we have to be careful. Okay. The coefficient of Vc has to be 1. In that case, the coefficient of dVc by dt will be the time constant. Okay. So, it is called time constant because clearly RC has dimensions of time. We have exponential minus t by something. So, this has to have dimensions of time so that we have exponential and inside that some dimensionless constant, dimensionless number. Okay. So, this is called the time constant. Okay. Any questions about this? So, like I said before, the initial slope is Vp by RC. Okay. Now, at t equals RC, what is the value of Vc? What is the value of Vc at t equal to RC? Please try to calculate this. Okay, many of you are able to answer this. It is Vp times exponential of minus 1 or Vp divided by exponential of 1, or numerical value is 0.3679 times Vp. Okay, so if I mark one time constant over here, okay, this is t equals RC. Maybe it's not to scale, I should redraw this a little better. Okay. Okay, so that's what happens. And here the value is 0.3679 Vp. Okay. Now if I go to two time constant, it will be 0.3679 square and so on. Okay. So it will be approximately 0.1353 and it will rapidly reduce. Now it turns out that after approximately 5 time constants or 4.6 time constants, it goes down to 0.01 Vp. Okay. T equals 4.6 RC. Okay, we approximate this to 5 RC. The point here is that it will never completely discharge to zero, because if you look at this function Vp exponential minus 3 by RC, it will never become equal to zero. Okay, it becomes equal to zero only when t tends to infinity. So in a finite time it never goes to zero, but it becomes arbitrarily small. Now how small you want it to be depends entirely on the context. Sometimes you may want it to be 0.1% of the initial value, that is 0.01 Vp. Sometimes you may want it to be 0.1% or even smaller. Okay. But this is a good number to remember. For the voltage to reduce to 1% of the initial value, you have to wait for 4.6 time constants. Okay. So many times the time constant is denoted by the letter tau. And for this circuit, it is equal to RC, and in 4.6 time constants, it reduces to 0.01 Vp. Okay. Any questions about this? So, when the input steps from some value to zero, we know how to solve it. We have the homogeneous equation. And by solving the homogeneous equation, we get the output to be an exponential, and this is the zero input response also, meaning we have calculated this response for the period when the input is zero. Okay. So now let's get back to the other case where we have R and C. Okay, Vs, and the differential equation governing this is RC dVc by dt plus Vc equals Vs. The right hand side is no longer zero. Okay, so again I will not take arbitrary functions for Vs, but I will take something that jumps from 0 to Vp at t equal to 0. Okay, so this is, this red stuff is Vs of t. So for t greater than 0, the right hand side of this is a constant equal to Vp. Okay, so now we already intuitively evaluated that it starts with a slope of Vp by RC, and it will do that. Okay. it will do something like that. So now we also have to find a function that corresponds to this. Okay. So any idea what this function might be? What might be this function? Okay, so there are a couple of answers. One of the answers is Vp 1 minus exponential minus t by rc. That's correct. In fact, we'll derive it properly. Also, there is an answer saying positive exponential. I'm not sure what is meant there. If you mean that the argument of the exponential will be positive, that's not correct. Because if the argument of the exponential is positive, you will get a curve that is like this, right? So it will go on increasing. It will blow up. Okay, at t equal to infinity, it will become infinity. That's not the kind of function we have, as we have determined from intuition. Okay, so it turns out that we can very easily derive this, because we know the result to the previous one when the right hand side is 0 for the homogeneous equation. In a very easy way, we can reduce this to the homogeneous equation. Okay, so there are standard tricks in calculus that all of you are familiar with, I think. So let me redefine a VC1, which is VC minus VP. Okay. Now, please tell me, so VP is a constant. So keep this in mind. So what will be dVC1 by dt? What is this going to be? If VC1 is VC minus VP, what is dVC1? What is dVC1 by dt? So please tell me what is dVC1 by dt if VC1 is VC minus VP. So clearly, if Vp is a constant, dVc1 by dt is the same as dVc by dt. Okay. So what I will do is, I will rewrite this equation in terms of the new variable Vc1. Okay. So first of all, dVc by dt is the same as dVc1 by dt. And if you see this, I have Vc minus Vp equal to 0 if I take Vp to the left side. So that is nothing but Vc1 equal to 0. Okay. So here Vc1, in terms of Vc1, this is a homogeneous equation with the right hand side to be 0. Vc1 is just a new variable I have defined. Okay. So while solving problems, you do this all the time, right? You define some variable in terms of other variables and substitute. In this case, I have defined Vc1 to be a variable Vc minus Vp. What I want to calculate for is Vc. So instead of that, first I will calculate Vc1 and from that I will calculate Vc. Okay. So if I do that and write the differential equation in terms of Vc1, I will get a homogeneous equation. Okay. So Vc1 would be of the form V0 exponential minus T by RC. So Vc, if I turn around this one, Vc is Vc1 plus Vp. Okay. So Vc will be of the form Vp plus V0 exponential minus T by RC. Okay. Is this fine? So this is the general form of the solution to this equation, which has Vp on the right side. Okay. So this is not a homogeneous equation, and the solution to this will have Vp. It will also have some terms like exponential minus T by RC, which was part of the zero input response. Okay. And it has this constant V0, which we have to adjust based on the initial conditions. Okay. So what is V0 and Vp? First of all, Vp is the size of the step, right? Vp, the input jumps from 0 to Vp. Okay. So that is Vp. And V0 is just a constant. Okay. So previously here, I said that Vc will be some V0 times exponential minus T by RC. That will satisfy the differential equation. And we calculated the particular value of V0 by looking at the actual solution at t equal to 0. So V0 happened to be Vp in the previous case. Okay. In this case, again, we have to evaluate the value of V0. We'll do that shortly. Okay. So now we have to evaluate the value of V0. What we'll do is, I know that Vc of t is Vp plus V0 exponential minus t by RC. And if I substitute t equal to 0, what will I get? What will I get if I substitute t equal to 0 in this function Vc of t? So clearly, exponential of 0 is 1. So the answer is Vp plus V naught. Okay. Now, what is the value of the function? Actual value of the function at t equal to 0, it is 0, right? That we know. Initially, the capacitor has 0 volts, and just after the input step, the capacitor still has a value of 0 volts. So this should be equal to 0, which means that V naught equals minus Vp. Okay, it is clear. So there will be arbitrary constants in the solution to a differential equation, because the differential equation in the general form could be satisfied for any value of this constant. But by looking at the initial condition, you will be able to find the particular value that satisfies it for that case. Okay, so in this case, this V naught equals minus Vp. So the actual solution to Vc is Vp minus V naught exponential minus t by RC, or minus Vp, sorry, Vp minus Vp exponential minus t by RC. Also, frequently this is written in this form, Vp 1 minus exponential minus t by RC. Okay, so if you look at the solution here, at t equal to 0, both are Vp and this cancels out, or inside this, this exponential will be 1 at t equal to 0 and you have 0. And as t becomes infinity, this exponential part becomes 0. So Vc of t will become Vp. That's what we see from our intuition. And it starts from Vp, starts from 0 and then exponentially approaches this Vp. Okay? Is this clear? Any questions? So, okay then. So, we have looked at the RC circuit. It is governed by a differential equation. We have solved for it intuitively. We know what it means. Okay. That is very important actually. We of course taken a special case of only constant inputs. When I say constant, it jumps from one constant value to another constant value. Okay. Now, if it does that, what happens to the capacitor voltage? And we will see later that this happens to every variable in the circuit, is it undergoes some change with some exponential argument. And the argument inside will be minus t by RC or minus t by some time constant. Okay. Now we solved it for zero input. That is, you have some initial condition and the input then jumps to zero. We also solved it for, you have zero initial condition and it jumps to some value. Okay. So let me just tabulate the results. The circuit we are looking at is this. RC, and the variable I am trying to calculate is this. I took two kinds of inputs, one where the input jumps from some Vp to 0, okay, and in this case the capacitor voltage Vc will do something like that, okay, and the other case was where the input jumped from 0 to Vp and the output, it turns out, does something like that. Okay, this is Vc of t, Vc of t. So this corresponds to basically a 0 input, and in this case we have a 0 initial condition on the capacitor voltage. Okay. Now the capacitor voltage is also known as a state. A capacitor can hold some voltage, so that is known as the state of the capacitor. So this is also known as zero initial state or zero state. Okay. So the differential equation governing the zero input circuit is that the important thing here is that you have terms containing Vc and its derivatives, and the right hand side is zero. Okay, so this is known as the homogeneous equation. And in the other case, the differential equation is Rc dVc by dt plus Vc equals Vs. And we are talking about constant values of Vs or Vp. Okay. And the solution to the zero input case, it turned out, was Vp exponential minus t by Rc. Okay. And the solution to this case is Vp minus Vp exponential minus t by Rc. Okay. So we will look at these expressions and classify them into different parts. Okay. It turns out that this part is called the forced response. This is the natural response. The entire thing is the zero state response in this particular case. And this is the zero input response. We will look at all of those things in the next lecture. So if you have any questions now, I'll clarify them. Any questions about any of this? RC circuits and differential equations? Okay, I will see you on Thursday. Okay.